Okay, so I've been thinking and trying to run maths or similar GPU testing software on this guy, and I realized I don't have much chance. See, if you look at the motherboard for this, the GPU memory, that's actually the HBM or similar. That's the GPU memory, that's the GPU, that's the CPU, that's probably the PCH. And the way I found that out, if you look at this, and we can see it here. Yeah, HBM2, that's the memory. So there's no way I'm going to be able to. I don't think there's a reballing issue. I mean, if they had the VRAM separate modules, we can do something about replace and whatnot. So I don't think there is anything we can do on this. And attempting to run such things is not going to be a success. It's just going to be a failure. So the only thing let me check some notes on this job. Okay, so we'll let this guy shut down. Now, is this problem a screen issue? Well, we couldn't even repeat the problem, yeah? So what we will do is this. We'll put our own Windows 11 SSD. We'll do all the driver updates. And I'll try to repeat the problem. I'll let it sit on the side. I'll do it for the whole day. And when it crashes or have artifacts on the screen, I will try to get the recording up again, and we'll try and capture the recording, capture the event. Yeah, I was going to actually put some screws. What happened now that it doesn't want to charge? What the hell is wrong with you? Okay, we got white light. We got charging light. Okay, now we have charging light. Such a weird system. Yeah, so for this one, we're going to actually go ahead, do some major updates. And we'll run Heavenly. Okay, maybe this charger is no good. Let me get another charger. Where is a HP charger when you need one? Okay. We'll use I forget the name. We'll use that plus GU. Oh, you're shit. OCCT. I'll get the charger organized. Why was it removed? I think it has done a GPU update. Check the device manager. Okay, looks like it hasn't come in yet. Right, we'll reboot. Okay, it's booting into main screen. So what is the purpose of system update? You can't even check shit. Oh, goodness me, okay. Okay, we'll let it continue. Okay, great. All right, after this we'll do the testing. Alright, so I'll let these tests run. I'll do a couple of other tests later on. If any artifacts show up, great, I'll put it on. Otherwise, I'll have a final video later on. Interesting problem. So this laptop works fine. This is the one that I did GPU testing and all the other things. It's gone off. Still on, but the caps lock light is not working. You can actually see the faint of light. Yep. You can see the backlight of the screen. It's actually still on. It is actually still on. And it's quite hot. I mean, I can hear the fan moving. Now this happened when I simply plugged in a Type-C to HDMI adapter to repeat an issue the user mentioned, that anytime they switch between an external screen to the internal screen, this weird behavior will happen. So you can see the backlight, it's on. So this is a standard Type-C adapter port. It's not responding anymore. Nothing. I've got external screen set up there with power. No reaction at all, because I can monitor the screen's power usage as well. Interesting. Okay. Because I was going to conclude the issue of this laptop is the screen and nothing else. Now I feel like I'm wrong. Okay. I throw the issue to some other tech. Now we've got the HDMI hooked up, and we're going to see, oh, come on, not that now. See if it will come up. We don't want to show any, oh, this is our SSD. It's okay. Okay. And still, no output to the monitor. Okay, so we're going to disconnect this. Okay, reconnect. No, nothing's on the external. Nothing's over there. Now I'm going to hook it up to OBS so the screen will go dark, but it should display on your screen. Yeah, so what's wrong with that monitor? Maybe I need to change the input, let me see. I'm an idiot, okay, what's off? Okay. Alright. Now we're gonna use Type-C. Then there was a delay. Okay. Now Windows P extend. We got one screen here. Let's move it to the other side. Alright, so we got slash dot open on the other side. Okay. So where does the lines appear? How can we repeat this problem? Can't set 1600-900 full screen mode, okay. The top screen is part of the laptop. Okay, I'm gonna disconnect the Type-C controller and reconnect the second Type-C controller, which is this one here. Let's see the behavior. Yep, it worked perfectly. Let's read the user notes one more time. So this laptop is a 4K screen. It flickers, they say. Refresh rate. Let's see, 40 Hz. Keep 60 Hz. Keep. It flickers. How does that work? It flickers. Internal screen flickers, not the external. How can I repeat the problem? Does it depend on type of content that's being displayed? What we shall do is play videos on one screen and play a video on the other one. Okay. Trying to think what we can do. Performance seems to be slow. What's the performance? Because that's still running. Okay. So I moved it to the top screen. Okay, that's what we should do. Yeah, that's an interesting one. Okay, I'm gonna let it run, play some videos, and I'll come back to the video later on, see what happens. Okay, this computer that was dropped, and we can't find the fault with it. And screen goes funny when it's connected to an external screen. That's the issue. I believe it's maybe on a lower battery. Yeah, okay. We'll do one quick inspection of the motherboard. I wanted to turn it on to have a look at a potential problem. These are max screws. Okay. So, although the board works, we suspect there may be a damage or a missing component or something on one side of the board. So, let's have a look. That explains a lot. Okay. If the damage was on that side, see that? Then there is a very high chance the BGA chip here has cracked all the joints. That is usually a thunderbolt or something similar. Let me have a look. Okay. Yeah, JHL. JHL 6540. JHL6540. Yeah, Thunderbolt 3 controller. Okay. Really? You piece of shit. Fail, you break on my hands. Now's not the right time, man. Okay. That one too? Oh, man. Okay. Okay. So I think I know the problem. So how can we... Because I haven't been able to repeat the problem. I need to repeat the problem and then apply a fix and then see the difference. Okay. We need power. And this guy is fussy, he wants exact power. Okay, in this case, all right. Doesn't this board also take type C? Let me see. It's not taking any power. Maybe this one works off the mains. It's giving us the same weird problem as before. We wouldn't get the charging light come on until we disconnect this guy and then reconnect. White light comes on. Orange light. And then power. Okay. So we might see the external screen come up as our USB, our Type-C controller to HDMI. Yep. Let's try another port. Let's try extend. I can't repeat the problem. Yeah. I can't repeat the problem that they mentioned. Internal screen goes fuzzy or some weird colors or something. Okay, what I'm going to recommend them to do is this. Reflow that chip. And GPU upgrade of the software and whatnot. That's the best we can offer. Okay, let me just try to rotate this a little more. Okay, I'm going to push down the chip a little bit. I mean, it's a VGA chip. We don't want to push it too much. Just fiddle around with it. Okay. it's a duplicate at the moment. Something's on the external screen. Okay. Try the other port. Okay, what version of GPU drivers are we running? Okay. What I'm going to do is bring in the client SSD and try and repeat the problem using their SSD. All right, let's connect an external screen. I have to blur the username section. Blur. Yep. Okay, still nothing. End. And duplicate. Okay. I'll advise the customer and see what they want to do. I'll be right back. Okay, in this case, we're going to wait for customer's decision. We don't think it is a GPU or a screen issue, but rather most likely from the drop and major damage to maybe the BGA chip. Maybe it needs reballing. Yeah, we'll leave it at that for now. All right, thanks for watching. See you in the next one.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to support this channel.